Hey everybody, this video is about graphical transforms. We will discuss changes you can make to an equation and how these changes will impact the graph of the equation. In particular, we're going to focus on three transforms known as translation, reflection, and scaling. Learning how to anticipate the graphical change that results from applying one or more transforms provides us with the ability to graph a whole family of shapes by just knowing the graph of a single basic shape. Here's some basic equations and the related graphs that you have most likely been exposed to already. Y equals x, y equals x squared, y equals the absolute value of x, and x squared plus y squared equals r squared. The first transform we'll consider is translation. A translation is an operation that moves every point in a shape by some constant distance in a fixed direction. Visually, the shape has not changed. It has just been moved to a new location. We could use any direction, but we're going to limit ourselves to moving just horizontally and vertically. This is not as restrictive as it sounds, since every translation can be broken down as a horizontal translation followed by a vertical one. There's a tendency when working with transforms to reverse the result, because while we think of a transform as changing the graph, it actually changes the axis system. For example, if we have a lowercase xy axis and an uppercase xy axis, which is 4 units to the right, then we can move points like the red one shown here by just adding 4. However, if we solve this for the lowercase x, so x is replaced by x minus 4, from this point of view, it appears the point has moved to the right 4 units. So the rule we use for translating a graph is as follows. If you replace x by x minus h in your equation, this will shift your graph h units to the right, or in the positive x direction. If you replace x by x plus h, your graph will shift h units to the left, or in the negative direction. Similarly, if you replace y by y minus k, this will shift your graph k units upwards in the positive y direction, and replacing y by y plus k will shift your graph k units downwards in the negative direction. This seems a bit counterintuitive, since a minus h moves positive and a plus h moves negative. But remember, a plus h actually moves the axis in the positive direction, which makes it appear that our graph has moved in the negative direction. Consider the following examples. Suppose we start with the basic graph y equals the absolute value of x. In this case, if you have forgotten, it's the V-shaped graph shown here. You can plot a few points if you need to convince yourself. Now suppose we wish to graph the following, y equals the absolute value of x plus 4, y minus 2 equals the absolute value of x, and y plus 2 equals the absolute value of x minus 3. For y equals the absolute value of x plus 4, we've replaced x by x plus 4. Based on our discussion, this results in a horizontal translation 4 units in the negative x direction. So we get the graph shown here in blue. The original is shown in light blue for comparison purposes. For y minus 2 equals the absolute value of x, we've replaced y by y minus 2. So this results in a vertical translation 2 units in the positive y direction, as shown here in green. And finally, y plus 2 equals the absolute value of x minus 3. Now we've replaced y by y plus 2 and x by x minus 3, so this results in a horizontal translation 3 units to the right and a vertical translation 2 units down. The resulting graph is shown here in purple. You may have seen instances of translation in the past and just not recognized it. For instance, recall that the graph of a circle, x squared plus y squared equals 9, is just a circle centered at the origin with radius 3. Now suppose we wanted the graph of x minus 2 squared plus y plus 3 squared equals 9. We've replaced x by x minus 2 and y by y plus 3. This is similar to our last example. The result will be to translate our circle 2 units in the positive x direction and 3 units in the negative y direction. This moves the center of our circle to the point 2, negative 3, and the radius is still 3. In general, x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared will move the center of our circle from the origin to the point hk. We can make a similar argument for the parabola y equals x squared, which opens upwards and has its vertex at the origin. Now if we want to graph y minus 3 equals x minus 2 squared, we've replaced y by y minus 3 and x by x minus 2. So this will translate our graph 2 units to the right and 3 units upwards. So the vertex moves from 0, 0 to 2, 3. In general, y minus k equals x minus h squared will move the vertex from the origin to the point hk. The next transform we'll consider is reflection. Specifically, we mean 2D reflection about a line. You can think of the line as being a mirror, and the reflection of a point appears the same distance away on the opposite side of the line. A reflection does not give you exactly the same shape you started with. For instance, a right hand becomes a left hand in a mirror. Orientation is reversed. Another way to think about reflection is that the original shape is revolved in 3D around the mirror line by 180 degrees. We're going to limit our discussion to reflecting across the x-axis and y-axis. This is in fact quite easy. Imagine reflecting the point 4,2 across the y-axis. You can see we get the point minus 4,2. In particular, the y-value stays the same and the x-value is reversed. Similarly, if we reflect across the x-axis, the point 4,2 becomes 4 minus 2, so the x-value stays the same and the y-value is reversed. In general, if we replace x with minus x, this reflects our graph across the y-axis, and replacing y with minus y reflects across the x-axis. Our next example uses an exponential graph. Don't worry if you've never worked with this before. The equation y equals 3 to the x is shown here with its graph. Assuming that this is correct, what would be the graph of y equals 3 to the minus x, minus y equals 3 to the x, and minus y equals 3 to the minus x? For the equation y equals 3 to the minus x, we've replaced x with minus x, so this results in a reflection about the y-axis. The graph of this is shown here in dark blue. For minus y equals 3 to the x, we've replaced y with minus y, so this will cause a reflection across the x-axis. This new graph is shown here in green. And finally, for minus y equals 3 to the minus x, we've replaced x by minus x and y by minus y, so the original graph is mirrored across both axes. It does not matter which one you do first, the result will be the graph shown here in purple. The equation y equals the absolute value of x is slightly less exciting, but it does have an interesting quirk to it. If we replace y with minus y, the graph of minus y equals the absolute value of x will be our original V shaped reflected across the x-axis as shown here. But what happens when we replace x with minus x? We mirror our graph across the y-axis, but in this case the graph is the same. That's because the absolute value of minus x equals the absolute value of x. A function f of x with the property that f of minus x equals f of x is called an even function, and the graph will be symmetric about the y-axis. The final transform is scaling. Scaling is an operation which involves stretching or shrinking our shape in a particular direction. If we stretch or shrink all directions by the same amount, we have what's called uniform scaling, and this is basically the same as zooming in or out. The shape stays the same, but gets proportionally larger or smaller. If we only stretch our shape in one direction, we get what's called non-uniform scaling, and that's what we wish to consider here. In particular, we're concerned with stretching or shrinking in the x and y directions. In order to scale a graph, we'll replace x or y by a constant times the variable. Scaling is like translation in that the graphical result seems to be the reverse of our intuition. Suppose we create a new axis, capital X, which is twice our original axis. So what used to happen when lowercase x was 4 will now happen when capital X is 2. This is like stretching our axis values away from the origin. But notice that when we return to a uniform grid, the point that used to be at 4 is now shrunk back to 2. So the graphical effect is the reverse of what you might anticipate. Stretching the axes will shrink the graph, and shrinking the axes will stretch the graph. In general, if we replace k by k times x, then our graph will stretch horizontally. It's pulled away from the y-axis if the absolute value of k is less than 1, and it'll shrink horizontally towards the y-axis if the absolute value of k is bigger than 1. So big numbers make the graph smaller, and small numbers make the graph bigger. Similarly, replacing y by k times y will stretch or shrink vertically either towards or away from the x-axis. Consider this half circle of radius 20 given by the equation y equals the square root of 400 minus x squared. Suppose we were to replace x by 2x. Since our scale constant 2 is bigger than 1, this is going to shrink our graph horizontally, so now it only goes from minus 10 to 10. The scale factor of 2 makes the graph half of its previous width. Also notice that the height is not affected by adding a scale factor to x. Here's a more complex example using the sine function, shown in the graph here. the graph of the sine is a wave which oscillates between minus 1 and 1, and it repeats itself every factor of 2 pi. Now suppose we replace x by 2x. This will again shrink our graph, so we now have a wave which is only half as long. What if we replace x by x over 3? Since 1/3 is less than 1, this will stretch our graph horizontally and make it 3 times longer. So one wave now takes as long as 3 of our old waves. And finally, what about y over 3 equals the sine of x? Since we're replacing y by 1/3 y, this will stretch our graph vertically away from the x-axis. So the length of a wave is unchanged, but the height, or the amplitude, now travels between minus 3 and 3. Of course, all these transforms can be combined, creating multiple changes to our graph. If you start with some basic equation, and you make sequential transform changes to get your desired equation, then you can make the same sequence of changes to your graph. For instance, we can graph minus y equals the sine of x minus 1 by starting with y equals the sine x. Then we know that minus y equals the sine x will be the reflection across the x-axis. And finally, we can replace x by x minus 1 in the reflected graph, which will translate it one unit horizontally to the right. How about x minus 2 over 4 squared plus 2 times y plus 1 squared equals 1? Start with the unit circle, x squared plus y squared equals 1, and now replace x by x over 4 and y by 2y to get x over 4 squared plus 2y squared equals 1. This will stretch x horizontally by a factor of 4 and shrink it vertically by a factor of 1/2. Now we can replace x by x minus 2 and y by y plus 1, which will result in a horizontal and vertical translation, moving the center from 0, 0 to the point 2, negative 1. So in summary, we described three transforms: translation, reflection, and scaling. For a horizontal translation, we replace x by x minus h. For a vertical translation, replace y by y minus k. For a reflection across the y-axis, replace x by minus x. For a reflection across the x-axis, replace y by minus y. And finally, replacing x by k times x, or y by k times y, will stretch or shrink your graph horizontally and vertically. So I hope you found this video helpful. Please feel free to leave comments or suggestions. You can watch more of my math videos at www.mathforeveryone.info. Thanks for watching.
It's gonna have to be a different math.